Martyn, it's no secret that mountain biking and mountain bikes are expensive.
They can be.
But just how expensive are they? Well, today we're going to look at some of the most costly ones out there.
Yeah, right at the top. This could get pricey.
Having scoured the internet, we've come up with a list of stock bikes where the prices are up there, Mark, with boats, cars and motorbikes.
Yes, very good motorbikes and ropey boats. Now, we're going to be talking in pounds sterling, but you can see euros and dollars on the screen so you can make your mental adjustments. And this is a list of the most expensive bikes we could find. This isn't saying that this is where expensive bikes start. You can spend half the amount of money and it will still be a very expensive bike. And, you know, that's a really important point to make.
That's it. You do not need to feel pressured that your bike should be up there with the cost of these. These are crazy. You can have a great time on a bike way less than half the price. And extra disclaimer, the prices of these bikes that I've done on here, I've been on their websites and some of the builders and added, Mark, every conceivable optional extra as well. I went all out. So with that, let's dive on in.
Okay, first bike on the list, and I've got my mind blown right now because this is going to give you a barometer of where this list is going, okay? Because this was probably the bike I would have said that I'd spend the most amount of money.
Yeah, you thought it'd be up there.
Because I like this bike, right? It's the Yeti SB160 in turquoise. We're coming in at the top of the list, okay? 9,894. This is number 10 on our list.
Right.
It only just made it.
We're coming in swinging. Yeah, so this is the T4XX. Turk build. So this is their top of the range build. And on top of that, in this video, I'm going to be adding, like I said, all the optional extras on. So on top of that, I've added on a Fox DHX2 rear shock and DT Swiss EXE carbon wheel sets to get it to that price. And it's still at number 10. I mean, it's a stunning build. Kashima coated Fox 38s. Like I said, the carbon wheels, you got the SRAM T-type on there.
Yeah. And it's a lovely looking bike.
It's race ready.
If I saw someone on the trail, I would be thinking, wow, I've just seen something special ride by. Would I be thinking, 10 grand, wow? 10 grand?
That's a lot.
A lot of money, and we are only going up from here. I can't really imagine where this is going.
Well, it's going to number 9.
Next up on the list, it's the Santa Cruz Megatower. Should be the Santa Cruz Mega Bucks. Coming in at number 9 on our list, £10,500.
Yeah.
Penny under. Yeah. Unbelievable money. Unbelievable bike.
It is, yeah. This is the XX AXS RSV build in their CC carbon frame. So the CC is their top of the range carbon layup and sort of mold and things that they use. This thing's dripping in access parts again, Mark, so we're all wireless everywhere. Not the seat post, but just the gearing. RockShox forks, but with a Fox rear shock.
All right, well, it's quite the build. You've been on quite the shopping spree.
Oh my God.
You're having a great time.
I bankrupted myself ages ago.
I would suggest that it's actually a really fun thing to do, just go and spec a bike up on one of the websites. It's quite enjoyable.
Yeah.
But look how much money you can spend, and we're going to spend
so much more. Yeah, this bike, big travel, frame storage. It's got their reserve lifetime guarantee carbon wheels. We got, like I said, the full wireless. It's a monster, but it's not high enough on our list.
Next up, it's the Specialized S-Works Epic Limited.
Yes.
Okay, limited as in, who can afford this? £11,000.
Yep. We've broken the 11K mark, and this is the first XC bike on the list. So we've got two enduro bikes, now onto the XC stuff.
That's interesting, actually. Yeah.
Now, this thing is dripping with fancy pants parts, right? So we've got Roval carbon wheels.
Right.
Full access again.
Like it.
Power meter cranks. We got the wireless dropper going on this one. Mm. Guess how much that bike weighs? Not cost, because we know that.
I'd say it's like 12 kilos.
10.1.
What?
Yeah, it's super light. It's got their brain suspension, so that sort of specialised in-house suspension sort of tech and internals going on there. It's fancy. It's £11,000 worth
of fancy. I do feel, though, it's interesting that this is a cross-country bike, because I do feel like I'm getting a little bit more at this point. I genuinely am getting a bit more for my money here. I feel like that.
In terms of manufacturing, or like the parts on it, the power meter crank?
I think the parts, the power meter's on there. We've got the electronic dropper.
Yeah.
I feel like I feel like there is
more. You're getting your money's worth?
I wouldn't say that. I wouldn't say that, but I feel like, okay, it went up in money, but it went up in things.
It's very true, yeah.
And for some reason, Rich, I feel like a very expensive cross-country bike doesn't feel as bad as a very expensive something else.
Well, that's maybe because unenduro bikes get a hard life, right?
Yeah,
so maybe you're like, oh, it's going to last a bit longer. Flippin' hope so.
Yeah.
Right, onwards and upwards. Next up on our list is the ACTOFIVE Dream Build. Now, this is based around their P-Train frame.
Yes.
But their dream builds start from 11,187 Great British Pounds.
Woo!
Yes, but I mean, that P-Train is it's a pretty out there frame. It's pretty special. So it's a variable high pivot suspension frame. Adjustable travel from 145 up to 175, 180 mil up front. Like I said, it's a dream build. So you can choose from an absolute plethora of forks, drivetrains, wheels, you know, you name it out there. And it's quite cool, it's CNC'd, so it's two pieces of metal glued together, Mark.
Yeah, so I mean, this is a pretty special bike. I mean, that frame only is 6,750 euros.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're up in the area for this frame price of like a, you know, handmade boutique build.
Yeah.
You know, so you're getting an awful lot for your money. But it is an incredible amount of money. But we are starting to get to that space where, you know, we're starting to get some real trinkets with it all, aren't we? I like this one. Next on the list is the Orbea Rallon M Limited. And I like this one, right, Rich? Because you're a lucky man. You get to ride this bike.
Yes.
So I think you're going to have to admit that if you didn't have this job, you'd be buying this bike.
I'd certainly like to. I'd certainly be trying to, for sure. Yeah.
Now this is Rich's money we're spending.
Please don't. Please don't tell the missus.
Actually, and you spent more because you added even more. This is £11,399.
Yeah.
But you've added even more things to it.
I know. So the cool thing is, I went on the stock Orbea Rallon M Limited is 11,399.
Yeah.
And then if you go on their Myo Creator, you can obviously choose any colour and make it all jazzy.
Which you did.
Of course I did. But it doesn't cost you any more.
But then you did add some more.
But then I did upgrade the tyres and I upgrade to the Fox Cobalt axle as well on the front, and that bumps it up to £11,479.
That money just left your bank account.
Damn
least
it.
At least you can say you love it.
I do genuinely like that bike though, that is true. Now for your money, you get top end parts. Of course, Mark, like all of them you do. You get the full SRAM XX AXS wireless transmission.
Lovely.
You get Fox Kashima coated transfer dropper, 38 forks, you get the Fox coil rear shock. You know, there's ergon parts on there. This thing is an all-singing, all-dancing race weapon, I'd say.
Yeah, it looks nice, I've got to say.
But, you know, this is the halfway point of our list, Mark. So there's only one way to go. That's still up.
I'm starting to sweat.
Yeah, as is my bank balance.
Next on the list, something of a darling of the social media channels.
Yeah.
The Antidote Carbonjack. This is £11,528.
Yeah.
And I feel like this is the first bike on the list that I'm not getting quite as much for my money as I should.
You're right, Mark. This is, we finally surpassed the 11 and a half grand mark. Who'd have thought we'd be saying that for a start? That seems insane. Yeah, this is the Antidote Carbonjack. Very sort of boutique, handmade Polish brand. Carbon bikes, very sort of, very pretty to look at,
I think. Some people love these
bikes.
They do.
Love
them, yeah.
It's actually got a Design and Innovation Award from 2021. So that's, you know, that's a thing. That's a thing. That's 2,950 mil, known for their carbon finish. This build kit is full Ohlins, Industry 9 wheels, full SRAM again, but it's the older SRAM X01. So there's no electronics here.
Yeah, that doesn't feel like the spec I should be getting for 11.
Yeah.
11 and a half plus.
Yeah.
It really doesn't.
Now that build kit is what takes it up to that amount. And also you can choose your paint job. So I went and opted for the classic Stormtrooper paint upgrade.
Of course you did.
Yeah, because why not?
It's actually quite a cool paint job.
It is. But yeah, so we are above £11,500. I do think it's a kind of cool bike though. I like how it's very different. I like the raw carbon. It's supposed to ride very well as well.
Next up on the list is the Trek Fuel EX 9.9. It's a nice bike, £11,800.
Oh, yes, this is the 9.9XX1 Access Gen 6, so the latest version. Yeah. Although, oddly, it doesn't come with the latest Access. It's not got T-Type on it. It's got the older XX1 and XO1
mix. It's the second time that's happened to us.
It does come with sort of Kashima-coated everything, Fox. It does come with carbon Bontrager wheels. It does come with a wireless dropper. It does come with a hefty price tag. And do you know what? The e-bike version of this will set you back £13,500 to get a motor on it.
Now, see, if I was getting that for £11,800, I'd be slightly more on board because I do love the EXE.
Well, you ain't getting that, Mark. Yeah. You're going to have to use your legs, I'm afraid, on this one.
That's unfortunate.
Right, next up, Mark, one that I didn't picture it on this list.
No, I didn't. I've got to be honest.
It's the Giant Rain Advanced Pro Zero.
Right.
£12,499. And that's stock. That's like, you don't upgrade it in any way. That's as it comes.
Whoa.
Yeah. It's quite a lot.
I didn't expect to see this bike on this list, especially not in this position.
No, I mean, it's a bruiser of a bike. 160 out back, 170 up front. It can be made into a mixed wheel size, full 29. There's a lot of nice parts in it. Fox 38's Kashima. You've got the DHX2 coil rear shock, carbon wheels again. You've got shock whiz on there, which is like a cool thing for knowing your pressures and things like that. Again, electronic gears, but the older XX stuff, not the new T-Type, which...
Yeah, I mean,
it's a bit mind-boggling.
I'm surprised to see it on the list. I guess it's a Giant. It's gonna work. It's gonna be
dependable.
It's gonna be dependable. I guess that. But yeah, we're up in big, big money here.
Yeah, that was just a curveball to me.
Surprising.
But so that was 12.5 grand. Your mind's gonna get blown at this next one.
Well, I'm really looking forward to it. It's actually my favourite bike on the list.
It's okay.
To quote Bob Mortimer, she's a beauty. Oh my word. The Scott Spark RC SLTR bike. That's the one we're looking at here specifically. We have jumped up quite a lot of money here, Rich.
Over £1,000 jump.
£13,800.
My brain just exploded.
Yeah, but tell you what, the silhouette of this bike, man, it's good.
It looks
so good. It wins every race it ever goes in. And this one's got all the parts.
It does. So this, you know, largely helped in development by the man Nino Shirto himself, who he apparently knows a thing or two about bikes.
Two things.
Two. Yeah, £13,800. For your money, you are getting a very clever frame. You notice that shock is hidden inside the frame. It's a special Fox nude rear shock where they work in partnership with Fox and Scott to develop that. A Fox 34 step cast up front. Full, you know, top of the range SRAM XX T-Type, including the power meter cranks, because obviously this is an XC bike. You want to know your power numbers.
Absolutely.
Now, the Syncross wheels on this, and this is sort of Scott's own in-house stuff, Syncross wheels in this, are phenomenally expensive in themselves and bump that price up. I think they're about £3,000 on their own. And then you've got one-piece carbon bar and stem. Mark, it's a monster.
I feel like, though, if I was spending a lot of money on a mountain bike, I've won the lottery, I can spend any amount. This would be in my garage.
Really?
I like it.
It is, it's a very, you know, it is a very nice bike and it has got very fancy parts on it, but £13,800, Mark. When you say that out loud...
It's so crazy.
Hey, Mark, do you want to spend £13,800 on a bike?
No. No, I do not.
I wonder how many people do.
How much were those wheels again?
Do you know what? I'm going to double check right now. Okay, Mark, we've just been scouring, and I've seen these wheels for up to, on one website, £4,500 for the wheels.
Yeah, I mean, I want to make a point here, right? £4,500 is where I would, in my mind, be looking at top-end spend on a mountain bike.
Yeah.
I don't think I'd really... I get to ride some amazing stuff. I don't think I'd spend more than that.
No, I mean, they're very... Engineering-wise, they're very clever, so they're all carbon, obviously.
And I think that's a lot.
Yeah, it is.
A lot. I mean, I've just spent a lot on a mountain bike.
No, you haven't. You've just bought a set of wheels. Now you need to get the rest. But I mean, look, if you are after an all-singing, all-dancing, race-ready weapon that is probably, I would hope, going to last a long time...
Man, you could put this thing on your wall like a piece of art.
It's really, really good.
But, you know, you might have to justify the cost.
Mm. But now, for our number one.
This is ridiculous.
Behold then, people, this ridiculous bike. It's a bit of a curveball, all right. I've had a bit of a joke here.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
But to get to the top of this list, you basically had to plate a bike in gold.
Yeah.
I mean, this bike is actually pretty crazy. It's not only completely covered in 24 karat gold, plated, it's also got 6 carats worth of diamonds built into it all over the place.
Yeah.
Did you say the head tube's actually a piece of jewelry in its own right?
Yeah, and has 500 golden sapphires totaling 4.5 carat. Now, this was done by a company called the House of Gold. I'm not sure actually they're still going. But also, this is commonly known as the Beverly Hills Edition 24 karat gold extreme mountain bike.
Yeah.
This is an extreme mountain bike.
Yeah, I mean, one thing I'd say right away is it's borderline a mountain bike. It's only just, right? It looks like a mountain bike. If it didn't have all that stuff on it, it would basically cost about £300. Snoop Dogg ordered one of these bikes, and yeah, it's not a beauty, and it's a lot of money. $1 million.
I mean, it's a showpiece, isn't it?
$1 million.
Look at the saddle on it. Have you seen the saddle? Where, hang on, look. Look at the saddle here then, Mark. I mean, I don't know if that's some kind of crocodile skin, which is not a good thing in the first place. And if you're actually riding, I mean, if you're such a baller that you're actually riding this bike, fair play, but it's ridiculous.
Well, I tell you what, we found a very fun, light-hearted way to get to the top of that list by spending £1 million on a gold bike. But it's an incredible list, Rich, isn't it? I mean,
it
just goes to show how expensive mountain bikes have got. What do you think about that? Let us know in the comments. And is there one that you've found that should have been on that list?
Yeah, definitely,
there was
I reckon.
A lot of bikes out there you could have spent a lot of money on. Did you have a favourite, Rich?
They're all crazy. I mean, they're all very pretty, they're all crazy, but they're all far more too expensive for me.
Yeah, if you're spending that money, let us know in the comments where you can get involved in this one. Is it all getting a bit too expensive? I don't know. Let us know. Give us a like and a share. I'll see you next time.